That's like the age-old question, right? It's like, why should young people care? And why should young people vote? Because when you look at the statistics, young people do vote at lower levels than other demographics of folks. And so I think what it really boils down to is the fact that if young people recognize the collective power that they hold and harness that energy and turn out to vote in record numbers, there will be people who are elected that look like young people, that are young people, that represent the ideas of young people. And that's something that doesn't always happen in politics.
In recent years, the political situation in the United States has taken a downward turn, and many have lost faith in the system in Washington.
As long as it's surrounded,
I'll give you a copy of the proposal.
Young people are fed up with the lack of meaningful change in government policy and are voting in lower numbers. In the 2022 elections, only 27% of voters aged 18 to 29 casted a ballot. Many are shedding light on the issue of dismal youth voting numbers, but why is it happening and how can it change?
Hi, my name is Isa Musa.
My name is Mr. Randazzo. I'm a junior actuarial science major.
My name is Tom Bergen, and I am the voter engagement manager at Headcount.
Well, I've never been very involved in the elections that take place aside from the presidential election that's held every 4 years. However, after that election in 2012, which was Barack Obama's running for his second term, I actually have not voted for a presidential candidate since.
As much as I am like, oh, go vote, because I do think it is an important thing, I'm not very politically active, partially because I come from a bit of a place of privilege where I don't have to be politically active. You know, my rights are very often not put on the line. The closest I get to my rights being put on the line is when it comes to stuff like medical caps, like price caps on medicine. I'm a diabetic, so when I see laws and like bills put in place about like, okay, buying medicine from other countries or price caps on insulin, that's where I'm most invested, I guess, because it's where I'm most affected.
I've seen plenty of campaigns and candidates running and promising or really driving home to the voters that they're going to make a change and they're going to make healthcare more affordable and they're going to take care of those who need insulin. And maybe I'm not as well informed as some others are, but to me, I haven't seen anything really change.
But if you're a young person who gets really excited about a individual candidate or an individual cause, and you go out and you canvass and you do everything that you can and you go and vote, and ultimately it doesn't go your way, and a candidate who has the complete opposite beliefs of you wins, or you vote for this person and then ultimately nothing happens or nothing changes, even though it was promised, like, that is really disheartening for a newer voter or someone who's an inexperienced voter. And so I definitely do think that the political divide and the lack of action on issues that are important to young people can be a huge detriment to potential voter turnout.
Headcount is a nonpartisan, nonprofit organization that uses the power of music to register voters and promote participation in democracy. Founded in 2004 by Andy Bernstein and Mark Brownstein, the organization has become one of the biggest advocates for voter engagement in the country, and has done so by spreading the message at concerts and through social media. Headcount is committed to increasing voter engagement at the ballot box, but many Americans feel hesitant to participate. In recent years, politics has become extremely divisive. As the major political parties in Washington have become more polarized in their ideology, this polarization has worked its way into our everyday lives. Countless Americans, especially those in the middle, feel alienated. Some of these voters are extremely critical of the system that they still vote in, and others are so uninspired that they have no desire to head back to the polls. Many believe that the issue of division is exacerbating the lack of voting, and that this must change for the sake of our nation.
It's no secret. We're in a very politically divided environment here in the country. And every time in my life that anyone's ever asked me, are you a Democrat? Are you a Republican? Are you a liberal? Are you conservative? I respond with the answer that I'm me, you know, because I don't feel comfortable labeling myself as just a name.
I tried to vote for the independent parties during like the primaries, you know, for like the House elections or like the midterms. Because if you don't vote for the independents, they'll never get in. And you have to vote for the independents because if you vote for either party, nothing gets done because nothing has been getting done. Sometimes you need an independent in there to bridge the gap, you know. Although, you know, like you said, the two candidates were caucus with the Democratic Party, they try to walk a more middle line. And sometimes you need that. Sometimes you need a Democrat who might be willing to turn and be like, okay, the Republicans have some good pieces in here. I'm going to vote for this, and I'm not going to vote because it's not a Democratic piece of legislation, or Republicans on the same end. Because sometimes they'll just gang together and be like, we're not voting for this because it's a Democratic bill and we don't want it. Even though there's good things in that bill and things that should be passed, they're just not passing it because of party lines.
I think anyone that can look at the current state of our country with a unbiased eye probably sees the need for a little bit more of a coming to the middle, a little bit more of a conversation. And as much as I'd like to say, yes, I'd like to see that, I don't really see it as a realistic possibility unless there are some significant changes that I can't even really fathom at the moment what could happen to really open the door for a third party.
One of the ways in which we can kind of combat that and encourage young people that, like, it's still important despite this polarization and despite these issues is to encourage folks to acknowledge the fact that, yes, Congress is important, and yes, federal elections are important, but they're not the only thing that's on the ballot. When you go and vote, there's oftentimes going to be ballot initiatives which are directly decided by the voters. It does not matter about what politicians think on these issues. They can share their opinions on things, but if a ballot initiative is passed on a state level, it gets written into your state constitution. And like, that is powerful. And so there's going to be ballot initiatives when you go and vote. There's going to be local elections where your city council or your school board or your mayor are going to be making decisions on a daily basis that are going to impact your daily life.
Ahoy, and welcome to the Pirate Ship. I'm the captain, and for the next hour, I'll be guiding you to hidden treasures and unique songs. This week's set list, at least, is going to be a little different than what I normally play. This one's going to be a voting-themed playlist. So these songs are about voting, democracy. A lot of them talk about the way youth has power, and, you know, through voting, and that sometimes the only way we have power as a collective is through voting. So all these songs, some of them are a little bit more serious, other ones are a bit more goofy, and they range all over those genres. So we're going to jump right into it with a favorite of mine, and a 2000s classic, Waiting on the World to Change, from John Mayer. Please enjoy.
Many Americans, even those who are fed up and have stopped voting, still care deeply about our country's future. Most people want to see unity in America and wish to see the divisive rhetoric toned down. In finding a solution to the division, many young people don't know the exact answer, but would like to see a change in our political discourse.
Look locally and find candidates or causes or issues that are important to you on your city level or on your state level, and invest in those. Because if you invest in those and you spend your time and energy learning about, you know, candidates for your state senate, where there's going to be maybe 50,000 people voting in that election, and your voice really does matter Not to say that it doesn't matter in every election, but when there's thousands of people as opposed to millions, it matters a lot more, you know? I would say focus on those, because that is where you can kind of restore your faith in the system. And if you kind of reinvest in that voting, as many other people who are kind of the same demographic who maybe also are disheartened reinvest in that, all of a sudden we see historic young voter turnout.
To see us go through a months of advertisements that are just completely ripping apart each of the candidates, and then eventually one of them wins, holds their position, and everyone's supposed to just forget about all of the over-the-top negative attacks on these individuals. And then everyone's there shaking hands and smiling and clapping in the room after they just destroyed the other one's reputation for months. It just doesn't make much sense to me. And I'm assuming it probably doesn't make much sense to those younger than me. So I think the elderly in position need to really take a look at what's unfolding right now across the country and think to themselves, is this the direction they want things to go to for their grandchildren and great-grandchildren? Because the future doesn't seem bright to me, and I don't want to feel that way. He's the man who never
returned. Hey, to Charlie. And with that, let's raise anchor, hoist our sails, and head back to port. I thank you all for being part of my crew, and I hope to see you again next week. And I hope to see you guys at the polls. I hope all this music about voting and, making sure your voice is heard really kind of stuck with you. So I want to see you at the polls, because the only way you get heard is through the votes. So please enjoy, and thank you all for coming.